Hey guys, what's up? MrGamer45 here, back with a new game.
What up, quote, new?
Quotations around it. New game for the series channel. And it'll also be a new series. It's called America Truck Simulator. And as you can see, I already have a profile here. It's because when you load up the game the first time on a new computer, it forces you to do that. So, disregard that one. We're not going to be using that one. We're going to make a new one. So, if you haven't heard of the game before, it's an American Truck Simulator. That's why it's named that. But they're slowly expanding, like, west to east across the U.S. Right now they have California, Nevada, Arizona, and New Mexico as their states. New Mexico is their newest one. It came out like a month or two ago. I have not got it yet. I just haven't got it yet. So we're going to go to new profile. Don't know why it says that. We're going to name it MrGamer45. Yes, I am a male. Picture, we gotta choose a snazzy looking dude. Oh yeah, that's the guy right there. Preferred truck. I like this Peterbilt. I think it's a 579. Could be that one. Maybe this is a 389. I think so. I've played this game before, so I somewhat know the trucks. And for our logo, we're gonna do a nice bald eagle. So this one we're gonna do Michigan. Spell it right. 45 trucking. LTD trucking. Oh, that's all the room there is. We won't do the 45, we'll just do Michigan or trucking. Trucking. Oh, that's it. Alright. So we'll just do Michigan or trucking. That's about it. Playing English. Everything good? Yeah. So we'll go to mod manager. And I'm going to add just a few mods that I like. Yes, it was a Peterbilt. I only do this because obviously there's some mods where it's like I really prefer to have that mod there. Especially the longer yellow lights. That is awesome. Pretty much all of these, except I'm not doing that one. That's no. we'll do confirmed changes. Hopefully those mods are up to date and they don't crash the game. Yeah, everything's good. We're gonna do keyboard because I'm not cool. We're gonna do real automatic. Yep. I can use either AWS, or I can use the arrow keys, which I prefer that. So, we'll do that. Hit finish wizard. And I gotta choose my headquarters. I think I can choose between the three states I currently have. I don't want to do Vegas. I think of my other one I did. I have one on my laptop. It's not a game laptop. It's just like a laptop that I use for school. So it runs the game actually pretty good. The game doesn't demand a ton. And I did that out of Bakersfield. So on this, or was it Sacramento? No, it was Sacramento. That's right. I think I'm going to go out of... I'd want to go out of like a small town like Redding or Eureka or Hornbrook, Ukiah, Truckee. I wish I could go out of a small town, but the game won't let you, which makes sense. Why don't you go out of a bigger town? So I think I'll do. I'll do Flagstaff. Yeah, I'll do Flagstaff. We'll do Flagstaff. No, I know how to play the game. Well, I should have done it for you guys, sorry. Oh well, use packages. Packages. Read. Gone. Oh, that's one heck of a job, though. Right now, I have the settings on ultra, so the game should look absolutely fantastic. Enter. enter. At last, you have a chance to experience your dream job, driving a truck. Your own transportation company is now open most for business, but sadly, you lack the money to buy a truck. From now on, you'll have to work for other companies as a driver for hire. Your task is to safely deliver a load of used packagings to Walmart, Dock, and Flagstaff. Your employer has provided you with a vehicle and will cover all expenses. Don't let anyone down and arrive on time. If you arrive late or if you damage your truck, you get big penalty points. So, we'll do this. Let the game load. And I'm in this truck. So before I go, I am going to make sure my keys and buttons are all right. So yeah. That's fine. Yep. This one, I want that. This one, I want that. That's fine. This one's going to be the plus. Actually, no, wrong plus button. This one is going to be plus. Control, I want that as the differential lock. For the blinkers, I'm gonna do. No. There we go. I have a couple buttons on my mouse, so I canceled something on the right click. I think it was this. Audio, to find gameplay, that's fine, show truck limiter, our truck limit, everything should be okay, let's actually up the random road events. US dollars, USA, miles, pounds, fahrenheit, gallons, consumption units. Miles per gallons, US. I think I got everything that I like. Yeah, that is everything. Alright, go back to drive. Game. It was good that the game didn't crash. That means that those mods are fine. They don't piss off the game too much. So here we are. You see the back. I want to close up those mirrors. We're going to start the truck. Reset that to that. Go to F4. And we're going to lower the dashboard light to like there. F4 again. Nope, wrong 4. F4. I want to tilt the steering wheel a little bit. Actually, that's fine. Let's pull it out, though. Alright, we're going to hit F4 a couple more times so I can adjust the mirrors. Alright, we'll hit 6. And we'll hit 4. There is no side mirror, so we'll hit wrong button. 5. We'll adjust the side mirror. And 7. Like that down all the way. Oop, wrong button. Hit 1. Hit that. 1 straightens out. And we're off. So, put in drive. Should already be hooked up, so tell you what, the game runs really, really smooth when you are. Ow. And, ooh. Oops. If you can't tell, I haven't played this game in a while. Let's turn on some lights. Some map. Oh, it's L. That makes sense. Alright, let's do that. I can break. Actually, I want to do something real quick. I know I'm dinking around with the settings too much. I don't know why I did this is that. I mean, I won't ever have my hand on a steering on a mouse while I'm trying to drive. That was dumb idea. Oh well. Alright, so we're gonna do this. Stop, look right, look left, can't really see all that well, so we're gonna trust it's clear. Does it adjust? Yeah, it does adjust that. We'll do that right there. I'm gonna turn right here. And look, I think we have the right way, so. Do a really wide corner. Sorry, almost too wide. Alright, we're gonna stop behind this swanky canal. Enter, and let's do the play it safe. I'm not real good at backing trailers, and I can always change that later. So I want it right over there. So we'll go up and roll right in. Try not to hit the fence or the light poles. Oh, I passed it. Back her up. There we go, and there's the air brake warning going off. There we go. Got a whole $360 for that. Woo! So, that, as you can see, the game looks really... I've actually never played it on Ultra. So, I mean, I have, but it's, like, really laggy. It would be really laggy. So, as you can see, there's our porta-potty of a truck headquarters. This is your truck garage. It's a pretty basic garage. It may not be much, but it's definitely not much. Unfortunately, we haven't got anything to park in there yet, so there are no trucks in sight, except for the one that's gonna go past the screen. Right now. Once you've earned enough money and bought a truck, you'll be able to move in the world freely and run your own business from here. Sweet, I just bought this and it's already got graffiti on it. Nice. Good luck. Yes, good luck indeed.
I don't think you could buy trucks.
You could buy a truck until level 5, so I guess we'll just go to Jet Market. Quick job. And we're gonna do price per distance, because those are always good. So I go to that there. And overall, this is the highest one, so we'll do that job.
So here we go, we hop into our first non-scripted job in the game.
Hold on, I gotta adjust my keyboard real quick. I won't touch the settings anymore until the episode's over. Sorry. I got S. Sorry, I'm talking to myself. So, looks like we gotta leave that way. So, I didn't even bother touching the seat this time because I think it kind of becomes a pain unless you get until you get your own truck to keep adjusting the seat and stuff. It's a real pain in the butt. So they see me rolling, dipping. Hey, is that my headquarters? What a piece of junk! The speed limit is not that, so we're gonna slow down. And we'll just cruise along at a whole whopping 25 miles. Excuse me. And we come up and we have to make a left turn. Here. Look left, look right. In the way. I trust it's clear. Got a semi coming. I might want to jump that way. Man, I had a game. I had a game on my laptop. I was killing it on that game. It was not even fair. I had like $4 million. I had trucks up the wazoo. Yeah. So. And I could have done that game, but it's like, hey, what fun is that? I have more money to play with than what I know. I have more money than I know what to do with in that game. So, but you know what? I'll start a new game. So, here we are. I tell you what, this truck is really, really slow. So we're gonna jack up the speed to 65. Ooh, I think I have traffic offenses, so I'm gonna do 64. I didn't do that in the other game because I'd always be a little bit too careless. This game I'm gonna be a lot more careful. Plus, it's just more realistic. Here it is, 55, so we're not even there yet. So we can just keep on trucking. Thank you very much. Write my own jokes. We got the FedEx guy. He's tearing it down highway. I think this is I-17. I'm hoping it's clear. Nope, it's I-40. I don't even know how fast this truck could go all that fast. tell you what, when you do auto compared to low graphic settings, boy, does the game look a lot better. Even in low graphic settings, it still was pretty good. It wasn't terrible. I mean, I'm sure I'm getting 60 plus frames per second on this. Like, on World of Warships, with my friend Juicebox, if you look on the top left, I have 75 frames per second. In that game, I run on an ultra, or high, the highest settings you can run on. A lot better than the little rinky dink one I'm doing here. Oh, I got a double behind. I think they have, yeah, they have doubles. I think they may have triples. Triple trailers in the game. I think the triple thing is a mod, though. So don't quote me. It's beside an auto sailor, so that's cool. Oh boy, the speed limit is 65. Pay attention. Man, I was wondering why the cars are going so slow. I was like, why is everybody going so slow? Because you're going way too fast. Even though in Michigan you could do about 10 over on the highways, police won't really care unless you're like by yourself, the mill part. But if you're like in a pack of cars, they'll be like, eh, you're fine. So in Michigan, if you're not doing at least about 5 over anywhere except on like residential roads in like a suburb or something, you're gonna piss some people. It's just how we roll. Just how we roll. That's how we do that. This is how we do it. I do plan on getting the New Mexico DLC fairly soon. I don't know how soon, but I would like to get it. This must be an 18-year truck. Maybe it's a 13. I don't know if they have a 13-year transmission. Right? The speed limit just hops up unexpectedly sometimes. You're gonna have to drive with these meters cut out. It's hard to drive without them. We're gonna scoot right on over, because I'm sure I'm backing up traffic. Let's take a look. Yep. Oh, we got a little tear up in the asphalt there. Oh, this truck doesn't have a retarder, okay. Hello, Mr. Popo. Yeah, when this first game first came out, it was like every 20th car was like a cop, was a cop car. It was absolutely ridiculous. I think they've really adjusted it, though. Because, I mean, it was like, sometimes you'd see a cop car, followed by a cop car, followed by another cop car. It was like, that's not even realistic. I think they've really adjusted that, so that's nice, because, I mean, it was just like, really? What do we got going on here? Going over into the road. So we're going to hit the resume. Keep on driving. we're gonna get off the highway here. So we're gonna take off the cruise, put on the blinker, and hopefully bring the truck to a nice, gentle stop. And probably go into the line of traffic. Oh, looks like we have a green light. Oh, I'm going. I came to a stop, Mr. Policeman. And we have now discovered the town of Kingwood. So that's cool. What? Oh, I'm supposed to turn there. I was like so confused about what was happening. Alright, I might have to pull the other duty check, so let's put on the blinkers. Just button hazards, just come to a stop. Make sure it's clear behind us. No, it's not. If you guys are gonna wait, I'll go. Well, I didn't expect that to happen. That was kind of annoying. I didn't think it was going to do that. I'm sorry, but I might have to go into the settings and fix that. Alright, this one's wide. So we can come in sharp angle like this. Bring it back. Don't hit the pole. You had one job, not to hit the pole. What'd you do? You hit the pole. What'd I do? I didn't even know what I did. Oh yeah, we have this now. I definitely want to do longer distances. I kind of have a system to set this up. I usually do three or four long distances in a row. And then I do two or three high value, two or three fragile, two or three touchy time. And then I go do hazardous, and then I go 1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1. And then when I have all these first five filled out, and then I just leave everything on fuel economy. So we're gonna do that. We got some mail. We've got mail. Need money? We can help. Congrats. I don't think I can buy trucks yet. Oh, I can? I guess we'll visit selected dealer. I mean, I think this is the only truck I can buy. I guess I could buy any of the ones. Nope, for level 13, so I can buy this one or that one. We'll do the custom configuration just to see what I like. So I can't do any of this until level 10. This I have to keep at that, which sucks. It's only 150 on tank. Tranny. Or engine, I'm sorry, I can only do a 370. Although I have quite a bit. I could, another level, I could get one. Transmission. colors, I'd probably do like a dark gray. Maybe like a deep black. That's pretty good. I don't know. I definitely wouldn't do that custom color. I'm trying to be like economical as possible. I mean, you have all the little things. You know, let's do the driver's plate, which I could do, but I'm not going to. Oh, I don't have those side lights yet. I don't have to worry about warning flags. Oh, I do have the heavy cargo DLC, so. So all the possible tellers coming at level 6, except for one's at level 13. Whatever. Oh, I know what that is. That's the top line game tire. I can only do basic rim. Yeah. So, okay. I'm not going to get a truck now. I'm going to wait till maybe like level 4 or 5. Because I want to be able to have some money up. Built up money a little bit so that I don't have to take a ginormous loan, because I can take out $130,000, yeah. So, but the per day cost of it is outrageous, so I take out as minimum of a loan as I possibly can. So we're gonna go to quick jobs, price per distance. Ooh, we could discover Phoenix from Kingman. Oh, what do you have about a Flagstaff, though? Another one, the Phoenix. 2547. 2925. Sure, we'll do a heavy duty job. See how good I am at driving heavy duty since heavy cargo, not heavy duty. Heavy cargo since I haven't done that in a while. So we'll see how it goes. See how it gets on. Start up the truck. Oh, it's a train. I was like, what is that? Let's see what we got going on here. That's 123,000 pounds? That's hard to believe. Instead of Siemens, like S-I-M-E-I-N-S, something like that, then it's C-I-Men's, Simons. So, we will put the truck in drive, and we're going to get out of Dodge. We're going to crank it all the way to the left, because I want to be able to turn in a hurry. Pretty sure I got to go to the left to exit. Yeah. Don't hit the concrete! Oh, I don't hit the concrete. Man, I'm gonna have to get really used to driving, making wide turns. Oh, let's turn on the lights. That's every time. What game do I play that turns on headlights when you're off? I can't remember what it is. Maybe something else is wrong with F. Incoming, I'm gonna look to the right, because I gotta take a wide turn. Straight, so disregard what I just said, peoples. So let's make a left turn up here. Right, left, can't see squats. Up. Quick stop, we got a car coming. Nothing in the right. So this truck has one of the higher horsepower engines you can get. I think it's like 625. I think the highest one you can get is 650. This is 625, so it's got some muscle. And again, it's also pulling 123,000 pounds. Yeah, it's. This also has a retarder, which is nice. use cruise control. You know, I'll probably never use cruise control. Heavy cargo. Let's hit F1 and see what we got going on for the old males. Take out the signs. Make a right. That actually was pretty good. That was a really good turn. Let's put out the hazards. Here, now I tell you what, we pick up speed in a hurry when we go down. We do a downhill run. Oh man, that guy's flying. Alright, we're up to a decent low speed in terms of the hazards. There is one hill on this map. I think it's on the highway. It's not on the... I can't remember what highway it's on. It's in California. It's like a really steep, pretty steep slope. Like, if you're pulling heavy cargo, I think this is the heaviest cargo is 122,000 pounds. I think this is the heaviest one on there. It's definitely up there. Like, if you're pulling that and you don't have a powerful enough truck, it's like, it's gonna be confused. Then you have to go downhill too, like, just about a steep angle. One direction's steeper than the other. I think if you're going north, it's gonna be a lot steeper than if you're going south. Because this is actually, the game's loosely based off of, it's not like Train Simulator where it's like mile per mile. The game is 1/20th scale, so 1 mile in the game, or 1 mile in the game is 20 miles in real life. Okay, so it's not like Train Simulator where it's mile to mile, it's a 1-to-1 ratio, or Train Sim World's like that too. But even so, the roads are loosely based off of real life, so that's pretty cool. Like, they don't just throw it in highways. They try to, you know, have highways that go through certain cities. They go through certain cities. If they have a special feature to them, they'll put it in. Like on Route 66, they have that. On one part, they have the musical highway, which is if you go over the bumps on the side of the road, you know, like the warning bumps on highways, just right at the same rate speed to put in America the Beautiful or something. There's an achievement, a Steam achievement, if you cross the Colorado like 5 times or something, in all 5 different spots, you get an achievement or something, I don't know.
We got some grooviness going on. So we'll just barrel down this highway at US 93 towards Phoenix, Arizona. 65, we must be going uphill.
Yeah, we're going uphill.
I can physically see it, but I can also
visually see it. Not only on the windshield, but also on the speedo. Which two speedos are actually not like that perfect. One analog one is about a mile an hour faster than the digital one, which is kind of stupid. That on
See, I bet this bridge is on US 93 is there in real life, so.
And it's in that design to where it goes. It's like the arch design of the steel underneath.
So, you can also hear the bumps on the side of the road.
It's kind of nice. I mean, they put a lot into this game. The only problem is that they're not real. I'm sure they put a lot of time into making states and stuff to where, you know, states are actually good. They're not like crap. Junk, but it takes them a really long time to do states, which, you know, like at the rate they're going, they'll get from one side of the U.S. to the other in like 20 years. It'll take them that long. Maybe they plan on it. They plan on doing a lot more states quicker.
We'll just see how it goes.
About 2 hours in the time, and that's why you're slowing down. Well, I'm gonna squeeze right through here, aren't I, sir? Anyways, we have 105 miles left. We'll get there in about 2 hours.
I do plan on eventually getting like the Logitech G29 wheel. Okay, so why was it one lane for this far? Sometimes this game does weird things. It's like,
I don't think in this game they don't quite have the traffic. It wasn't even that difficult of a word to remember. Traffic AI, there we go. Even so, that's letters, that's worse. The letters, the GAI set up perfectly for heavy cargo. I'm sure they're working on like the AI a little bit, like they give you a little bit more room, a little bit more courteous. That guy right there, in real life, that truck probably wouldn't have turned right if they saw me that I was going. He would have gave me a lot of room.
Well, again, it's a game, you know, you can always fix it. It's because I don't have my beacons on. This truck has it.
Barreling along the highway here, going across a little have one in, I think, Sacramento Valley Levy that's like right in your eye. Gotta stop, and then you can keep the guy going.
Before we hop up to the highway, so.
I do feel like they captured the physics of driving a truck in the different modes, like, really, really good, really, really well. Like, you have the different modes, like, if you, like, a 15,000 pound load or trailer with a load in it, whoa. And a truck, same truck pulling 15,000 pounds will accelerate a lot faster than a truck pulling 40,000 pounds. And they've done that in the game really well. Your physics are done really, really well. Really, really well in the game. It's done good. I would almost say it's done great. Like the braking, the steering, all that stuff, how fast you steer at certain speeds, and how far the steering wheel turns at certain speeds, it's done good. Another thing I wish they'd add is a little bit more variety of trucks. It sounded like Peterbilt and Kenworth, which are the only two trucks, unless you get a mod. They have like Volvo or a Freightliner. Freightliner's a big one, at least in Michigan. There's a lot of Freightliners in Michigan. They might just not have the rights to it, but yeah, you have Volvo, Freightliner, you can do. Sterling, quite a few things, quite a few different truck names. I need to see what interstate or U.S. highway this was.
65 miles an hour. Right here at the authorized
speed. And it looks like that's to the left up here, so. We're gonna hop on the I-10 East.
This game compared to the game I play on my laptop, I'm gonna be doing things a little differently. Like, I'm gonna have the traffic defenses, I'm gonna have,
let me do the truck, show the truck speed limit, and that really only applies to, like, when you're in California. As the trucks have different speed limits. At least in Arizona and Nevada, in the main game, there's no truck speed limit. I was looking for it after day 25. Before Mustang. But yeah, I'm gonna be doing things a little different, make it more realistic than what I do. Power play day in my home time. As you see, if you look down at the bottom under the tachometer, it's 94 degrees outside. That's hot. That is hot. Just now reaching the city limits of Phoenix. And we have a big diamond thing coming up. Which this is actually done really, really well too. There's one in New Mexico, it's like called the now we're speeding.
These are retarders. Slow down. They're getting off right here. Let me go with nice guy. As we near our destination. I'm gonna turn right. Nice wide corner. Probably should have went a little wider than that. Settings, it looks like the actual video. Yeah. Oh, right here. Oh, that's convenient. There we go. Yep, and we got 1 of 9 achievements. So we got 376 XP for that. Not quite level 2, so we'll have to get to level 2 in the next episode. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I know this is a longer episode than I wanted it to be. It's only because I had to do the setup of things like that, so I chewed up about 5 to 10 minutes. So episodes won't be this long. I'll probably do 1 or 2 journeys depending on how long they are, and I might split them up into 2 if it's like really long. But I hope you enjoyed this. If you would like to support me on Patreon, link will be down in the description below. Like this video, subscribe if you haven't, and hit the little notification bell button. And hopefully you can be around to see the next episode. See you later.